My name is Wei Wang. I'm a postdoc at the Stowers Institute for Medical Research. I work with Dr. Alejandro Sanchez Alvarado, and I study tissue regeneration. Regeneration is a long-standing question in biology. It has attracted biomedical interest because of the potential of replacing damaged organs with new ones. Currently, there are still a lot of fundamental questions that have not been addressed in the field of regeneration. For example, while some animals, such as fish and salamanders, regenerate extensively, while others, such as humans, regenerate poorly, is not well understood. The central goal of my research is to understand the genetic mechanism underlying such broad disparity of regenerative capacities in vertebrates. Currently, the most popular regeneration models with powerful genetic tools are zebrafish and mice, which were divergent since 450 million years ago. Because of the large phylogenetic distance and differences in tissue composition, a direct comparison between these two species is very difficult. Therefore, we took an alternative strategy by introducing a more closely related species, the African killifish nosobranchus fazari, that is capable of regeneration. In this way, we can reduce the phylogenetic distance from 450 million years to 230 million years, and compare regeneration in tissues with similar composition. The direct comparison between the African killifish and zebrafish regeneration has allowed us to identify both similarities and differences in the genetic response to amputation. Although both are bony fish, we were very surprised that we observed twice more gene activated in zebrafish regeneration compared with African killifish regeneration. And without such comparison, we wouldn't be able to discover such dramatic difference, and we wouldn't be able to discover or distinguish the species-specific response and shared genetic response between the two species. So our comparative studies have identified conserved regeneration-responsive genes and regulatory DNA. And we also call this regulatory DNA enhancers. And we found that these regeneration-responsive genes and regulatory DNA are also present in the human genome. And I cloned the human-derived regulatory DNA and put it in the African killifish genome. Surprisingly, I found they are also able to respond to amputation, but in a very different way compared with the same African killifish DNA. The activation was delayed and was in the wrong place. And because of such change, the human-derived regulatory DNA cannot activate regeneration in the African killifish. So this result suggests that the human regulatory DNA has repurposed its function during evolution, and we call this enhancer repurposing. And we think such enhancer repurposing could be an important mechanism underlying the loss of regenerative capacities in mammals, including in humans. Because of the presence of larger amount of species-specific genetic response, my work suggests in the future, comparative studies should be considered in regeneration studies in order to identify and investigate conserved mechanisms underlying regeneration. Although currently we are still unable to let humans regenerate, my work provides new insights into why humans lost the regenerative capacity of many organs.